You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
LAPD's on alert after gunman fire on patrol car. The warrior, as he's known, charged after threatening to kill cops and innocent, quote, white kids on Facebook. Talk about the winner of the Darwin Dummy Award. That's just some of the news we're going to break down as the Justice Department and controlled dinosaur media tried to foment racial and, of course, economic class warfare. But that's taking a back burner today. I covered that in great detail yesterday. This is just a smorgasbord of news. Asia Air CEO dumped shares days before flight disappeared. Move prompt speculation that Tony Fernandez had prior knowledge. Well, that happened on 9/11, too, on American and United at a record level. Four times any previous put option on the airline's decades and decades-long histories. Gallup, Hillary again tops Oprah on most admired woman's list. Totally disgusting force-feeding of that witch to the public. Pope Francis' edict on climate change will anger deniers and U.S. churches. Well, it's also just pure baloney world government garbage from the Jesuit priest. I'm no Catholic, but I know the basic law is that you never can have a Jesuit as a pope or even as a high-level cardinal because it's supposedly a guardian organization of the Catholic Church. So it's like third world countries always have the military take over. Or it's like back in Rome, you couldn't bring in the Roman legions past the Rubicon in the north. Out of what Switzerland today, Julius Caesar did that 40-something years before Christ was born. Pope Francis is the equivalent of that, bringing the legions into Rome. And now, ladies and gentlemen, he wants you to pay carbon taxes. He agrees with Obama that people in Africa shouldn't be able to have cars or air conditioners. So folks are always wanting me to attack the Pope. Well, you're going to get some today. Don't worry. Continuing, the war on drugs just got even more vile. Police to begin inspecting your poop. And this is a mainstream news article out of the American Chemical Society report and the Journal of Sewage Epidemiology. Let me explain something. They've been snooping the poop like a you-know-what house rat for a long time. But now they've got your blood samples in most major databases, and they have computerized systems that can instantly inspect through it, and then you're going to be getting a knock at your door. We snooped one of your poops, and it says you were using cocaine or Ritalin or Prozac without a prescription. Here it comes, land of the free, home of the brave. We're going to inspect your poop. The poop police. You've heard of the green police. Well, I'm sure the Pope will come out now and endorse the poop police. Of course, not his poop. When the pontiff travels, they have a contained toilet that goes with him, just like President Bush and Obama have, because they know that foreign governments and others try to get into the sewage lines to get that valuable intel. By the way, you think I'm... Folks, I'm going to mention this later. Print me an article from like 5-6 years ago about Obama's toilet and about Bush. Bush has his own toilet. Bush travels with his own toilet. Because people won't believe this if I don't show them that it's actually been in the news. Connecticut, studying whether hemp can be a new cash crop. Well, it sure is in Canada, and it has no HTC in it. So that's coming up today. Japan culls 42,000 chickens after second bird flu outbreak. Seals may have natural GPS. That's out of Fox News. We're going to be breaking that down. We're going to get into the Cowboys fighting with the Redskins yesterday and get back into that old 50-plus year rivalry. People say, why are you about to cover sports, Alex? You never cover that. Well, you'll see why. Also, gunfire at mall was someone banging on metal pots, say police. They say the wicked flee when none pursue. Did the U.S. and the Saudis conspire to push down oil prices? Well, remember the old Rolling Stone article, headline, everything is rigged. Of course it is. It's all coming up today and a lot more. Stay with us. I'm Alex Jones, InfoWars.com, PrisonPlanet.tv. Stay with us.
2015 is almost here, and with it comes those New Year's resolutions to finally transform your body the way you want it. There's a reason over 88% of New Year's resolutions fail. Make this year different by equipping yourself with OxyPowder, the next level in cleansing the body naturally. Using super oxygenation, OxyPowder, available through InfoWarsLife.com, gently cleanses the body while you sleep with easy capsules. Tens of thousands of individuals have used OxyPowder to cleanse their bodies and aid in their transformations. Even InfoWars Nightly News Director Rob Dew has been using OxyPowder with incredible success.
Took it that first day, then I took it for six more days after that. 12 pounds melted off in about a week. I'd say a week, 7 days.
2015 can be different. Diet and exercise are important, but a lot of us have already tried that. OxyPowder flushes it out. Secure your OxyPowder at InfoWarsLife.com. That's InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel body armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
The average person's life is filled with unexpected challenges. Unlock the energy it takes to defeat these daily beasts with Super Male or Super Female Vitality, specifically designed to assist the body in regulating proper hormone balance to create superior vitality in males and females. Supercharge and conquer your world at InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139.
Sold out for weeks due to the difficult and extensive proprietary process behind its creation, the exclusive InfoWars Life Secret 12 formulation is now back in stock in the last limited shipment of 2014. The most bioactive form that has been created with our proprietary process. This ultra-clean vitamin B12 nutraceutical has been carefully crafted and developed over the last 2 years and is based on cellular science of how your body actively absorbs essential nutrients. Secret 12 is taken by mouth, right on the tongue, and then swallowed. No needles, no injections. Vitamin B12 deficiency is linked to scores of serious problems. And Secret 12 is a fusion of two organic proprietary forms of vitamin B12, bringing you a true nutraceutical quality vitamin B12. Secret 12. Secret 12 is an excellent Christmas gift and is tailor-made to boost your New Year's resolutions. Supplies of Secret 12 are very limited. Secure yours today at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want to stop tyranny? Well, so does he. Live from the InfoWars.com studios, it's Alex Jones.
Take me through the centuries to supersonic years. Fani Hari, the very popular food babe, who's been shaking up Monsanto and other big companies. Her book isn't out yet for a few months, but she's giving us a sneak peek. She's under a massive demonization campaign in mainstream media and on the internet, and she wants to come on and talk about that today. But, I mean, that's a badge of success. That's an absolute badge of success. And in my experience, the more you get demonized and attacked and lied about, the more the general public loves you and realizes that it's all just made-up garbage. The traffic on InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.com doesn't go down when they put out a yearly fake report claiming the site has viruses. They always have to retract it because it's not true. They do that to Drudge Report as well. And they come out and put out just constant lies, constant disinformation, edit what I've said, misrepresent what I've said. This is what you expect. This is what happens whenever you are over the target. And that's an old World War II bomber term, of course. She joins us in the second hour. Wow, that said, there is just so much to cover. LAPD ambush. Police call off massive search for gunmen. Here's another report. Now Florida cops targeted. Deputies survived drive-by shooting. Justice Department grants linked to cop killing rap video that aired 1 week before the New York police were shot. A man known as, nicknamed The Warrior, charged after threatening to kill cops and innocent white kids. So that's the government's attempt to start race war. Look at this bizarre headline out of all the headlines. Seed libraries struggle with state laws limiting exchange. No, we're not talking about marijuana seeds, Mary Jane. We're talking about heirloom seeds being targeted worldwide by laws that are getting passed by the big GMO companies to not let people save and pass on some seed varieties that are over 6,000 years old. The ultimate crime is having a garden or saving your seeds or having a swap meet or shopping at thrift shops or shopping at local shops. This is how you control a population. You're not allowed to shop outside the company store. You're not allowed to shop outside the plantation store. You're not allowed to shop outside the reservation store. You got to go to the government or Walmart government-allied trading post. Seed libraries struggle with state laws limiting exchanges. Associated Press, gardeners in hundreds of spots around the country are sharing seeds as part of an increasing interest in locally grown food, but some agriculture officials say the well-meaning effort violates state laws. In spots like Duluth, Minnesota, the conflict has surprised gardeners and library officials who never thought to examine the intricacies of state seed laws. Agriculture officials say they weren't looking for a fight, but must enforce laws that are intended to protect farmers by ensuring seeds are viable, will grow the intended plant, and aren't mixed with unwanted seeds or weeds or plants. Yes, that's right. You're not allowed to trade seeds because there's seed purity laws. There are a lot of old laws. I have family that have been farmers for many generations on both sides, but there are old laws on you selling bags of seeds. They better be what you claim they are, but that's a civil issue. This country did great without all these laws. Now they're bringing it in, just like I saw in Michigan and in Oklahoma the last few years, where they passed laws or had city councils come out in the case of the second big city in Oklahoma. It's not Oklahoma City. It's the one Jakari's from. Tulsa. Tulsa came out and tried to pass a law banning backyard gardens, and the city council had statements like, because we don't know what you're growing, it could be marijuana. See, oh my gosh, you're growing something. We need to have an inspection because you might, you know, prisoners can't grow things in their backyards. This is why they have a war on lemonade stands that Forbes has written about. It's why they have a war on swap meets, a war on Christmas markets, a war on raw milk, a war on the Amish. Because a wild human, an independent human, is an enemy human in the corporate globalist Google, Microsoft takeover system. So knowing how to sew, knowing how to make a fire, knowing how to do basic metallurgy, knowing how to fix an engine. But that's why they don't want you to know any of those basics anymore. In the Great Depression, 1929, we've read the national studies here on air, 90% of the country was rural and most of them self-sufficient or somewhat self-sufficient. Today, look up the number. 90, right at 90 again, percent of the United States lives in a city or in a suburban setting. 10% live in the country, and wait for it. Of the 10% that live in the country, about half are seen as self-sufficient in major studies by the federal government itself. So we've gone from 90% on the land to 10% on the land. We've gone from over